name is Maja Petkovic. I'm a postdoc in Jan Lab. It's a lab at UCSF. So the main questions we are working on in the lab is how neurons, which are cells in your brain that allow you to think, see, laugh, whatever you do, this is what those cells are transmitting. A lot of diseases actually, and biological conditions, is linked with them not forming proper connections or not growing properly, or in the case, for example, of spinal cord injury, not being able to regrow. So understanding those basic mechanisms has a lot of potential actually using that for something that can be useful in a medical sense. But I think even just understanding how stuff work, I still find it incredible. So I'm Croatian, it's a Mediterranean country in Europe. So I grew up there, had a very happy childhood. I was not one of those kids who wanted to become a scientist. I wanted to be an archaeologist when I was little, then I had a phase of wanting to be a medical doctor because I had a lot of medical issues when I was a kid. I was one of those little sickly kids. And then I got super great, healthy, and then was sure I will become a lawyer or an architect. I was really crazy about architecture for like 6 years. And I still love fashion, I still love art, I love music, I love design, all of those things I still love. But near the end of my high school, I was kind of like, I'm not sure if this is really what excites me to the point, you know, you wake up in the morning, you're kind of groggy, you have your coffee, but you're so excited to go to work because it actually matters. And I had this discussion with my friend who wanted to study medicine at the time, and I was telling her, no, but you know, building beautiful buildings and bridges makes people happy, changes their lives. And she was telling me, yeah, but they don't care if they're sick, because she wanted to study medicine. I was like, huh. So I kind of ended up studying molecular biology, not really knowing what really was I aiming for. And honestly, it was love at first sight. And since then, I cannot really imagine doing anything else. When I was starting undergrad, I could not really perceive where I would end up, but it was a great adventure. So, I mean, I ended up living on 3 continents by doing science. There was always, you know, periods where you do much more experiments and periods where you do more analysis of the data, trying to make conclusions from what, you know, the experiments told you or reading the literature. So I think this is a horrible misconception that I also had when starting my undergrad, that scientists are very antisocial. That's completely wrong. I think scientists are extremely outgoing because you cannot really do science if you do not speak and exchange ideas with people around you.
That you can basically use knockout sounds compared to the wild type without doing the SI. That's the thing, because SI does not work.
I think they are very different personalities being successful scientists. They are very shy, famous scientists who are very successful. They're very outspoken and theatrical. I don't think there is a particular personality trait, but what all of those people have in common, what all of my colleagues have in common, is they're extremely curious, very persistent, and people who just really wanna feel like they're doing something that matters. I think those qualities are something that I feel it's common among most scientists. You know, I'm actually quite often, you know, you think about the questions you want to answer. You get passionate about knowing why and how. It's like you cannot give up. It's like, oh my God, I just need to figure it out. Every generation of scientists gives their contribution, and this is what I'm saying. It's like, all of us at certain point just bring a little small little piece, but we know today so much more than we knew in the past. And in 10 years or 20 years, you know, those kids that are now in elementary school, when they become scientists, they will know so much more than we know now. And I think that's kind of what the point is all about.